Hi there, it's DW from Welder Series. I'm here at my welding bench, and in this video I'm going to start the process of a step notch install on our 68 Dodge D100 pickup. I'll be installing one of our step notches that we sell, and you can assemble it on your bench in your garage. We sell it in flat plates like this, or it's available all welded up too. I'm gonna weld it because I'm the one that welds it anyway. So the first step when you're installing the step notch is to pull these plates all together. This forms the top and the front and the back and the bottom of the notch. And then the frame sits on here. And then this plate acts as a boxing plate, but also can come down to the bottom edge of your frame rail. So now I'll take you over to the truck and we'll get an idea of what we're working with. Okay, so here's the truck frame. I've got it mocked up at ride height, which is important because you want to know how far down the frame is going to go and how far up into the frame you need clearance for. So it's at ride height, my bottom bars are level pretty much, and I've got just a spacer in here. This is 1.5 inch block of wood to let it sit down and rest at ride height. This way we can also move it around too, and it's not gonna change anything. So one of the things that I wanted to avoid is having a big tray in the back of the bed. It's because I want to use the truck for hauling stuff or putting stuff in the back, and I don't want stuff off level or have stuff fall at the front and then be harder to get out. Well, I guess first of all, the top of the frame rail here is up against the bottom of the bed. And so the bed sits flat right at axle center line, and it goes forward from there. And then there's some, you know, blocks that sit on the top of the frame here and here. So I think what I'm going to do is build the step notch, weld it all together, and then I'm going to measure from here up 4 inches, and then see what it looks like when it sits on there. And then I'll know how much I need to trim, you know, out of this area to get this at 4 inches above the top of the frame rail. Then I'll be able to install the step notch and then cut out the inside of the rail here, and then that'll kick my frame over the axle so that I can drop down, and so that I'll have good suspension travel clearance. Alright, I'm gonna go build the step notch and I'll be right back. In the next video I might be wearing different clothes, depends how quickly I can work. There is another video of this online or on our YouTube channel, but I thought I'd just shoot it as a part of the truck build to show you how quickly the step notch can go together. So I'm gonna go from start to finish. I might speed up some parts of it that are boring, but wait a sec, it's all exciting. No, anyway, real time, don't even have my gloves on. Hey, I'm always trying to put them back in the right spot, but the thing about being alone in the shop is that I'm the only one to blame. I can't even say, hey, took my glove. So I start off by clamping this to the table with this slit just over the edge of the table. It doesn't matter really how much, but you just so clamp it back from the edge a bit so that it's holding it with more leverage. You just clamp it here, then it's easy for it to twist on those clamps. So then I use adjustable wrenches, which are also not where I normally put them, and then bend this one down. This is the one that you're going to want to measure, and so get that one to 90, declamp, reclamp, and pull this one up, and you can see that this one comes up and just kisses that corner there. So I'm going to throw a tack right there. Make sure you turn your gas on. Some of this that's not as much of a problem. So I'm going to hold this up against there. Put a little tack on, and it's easier when you're welding to cover it over. Now bend up the bottom, but don't quite get it to 90. I'll show you in a minute why. Can you wait? Suspense, so that this one will sit flat, and then your little tabs here will still rest against it, but it's just easier to set down. Another clamp. Clamp this one down a little bit loosely for now. Show you why in a minute. I use a sliding clamp here just because it has more travel. Then watch when you let go, it's going to shift a little bit as it pulls it pulls it into that wedge. Then I'm gonna put some tacks around the perimeter here. There you have it. That is one step notch. So now, sit on your frame. Obviously it's flat here. You may need to just trim that a little bit to get it to fit the curve of your frame rail. So why don't I just, I'll go ahead and weld this. Then if you want to see how I do the other one, you can just rewind the video a little bit and then play it again. I like to weld vertical down just because it flows into the butt weld there. Fills in the gap nice. So that when you're done, you may not even have to grind it. Maybe just touch up if you want to. I don't think I will. I do that because it just heats the tip of the wire a little. If you can do that and then get right into a weld, you'll find it'll go in without pop, 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 without, you know, fighting back at you. Okay, there you go. So to see me do the other side, rewind the video and press play, and when you see me do this, then keep watching. You'll know I did both sides. So I'm going to head over to the truck now and wait till this cools anyway, and then we'll go over there and see if we can mock it up. Well, what did I tell you? Different shirt. So I've got the step notch kit all welded up, and as you can see, it's got an extra long plate on the inside. That's to act as a boxing plate for the inside of the frame rails. So the C channel would go, you know, in here, and then this would be your boxing plate. You could trim that off either to sit like inside the C plate or flush against it. I was gonna say, if you remember from my last video, but this is all gonna be one video. So if you remember from 20 or 30 seconds ago, I said I only want the top of the step notch to be 4 inches above the top of the frame rail. So basically, I want this to be the top of my notch. So I'm going to have to throw another hand. I'm going to have to lower this down and then trim it there because, anyway, I'll explain that later. But anyway, the top of the notch, I want only 4 inches above the top of the frame rail. The other thing is the top of the frame rail is curved a bit. How do you transfer that curve onto the step notch? Well, my plan, I need to hold this 4 inches above the frame rail, and then I need to draw a line. And in order to make it easier to hold it, this is 2x4, so it's 3.5 inches tall, and this is 1/2 inch block. So I'm going to basically put this on my bench. So now I'm 4 inches above my bench. So this now is the height. I should be able to put this here. My frame rail is going to be right here. Okay, so that's at axle center line, 4 inches at axle center line. So I'm going to put this up against here, hold it. Now I'm going to clamp this block to my step notch. Now this is the top of my frame rail, and which is 4 inches down from the top of the notch. So now I can just set this on the frame, and I don't have to, you know, hold it while I'm measuring or anything. And then I can trim my line. If I used a longer block, then I wouldn't be able to use my marker to draw a line. So that's why I've got this short piece. So now let's go over to the frame, and I'll trim that line. I'll draw that line. Okay, so I'm back at the frame, and I have my block clamped on there. Now I need a marker. So I am going to get it mocked up. I'm gonna use a level close enough and get it vertical. Now I do have some interference back here with the shock cross member, but I'm pretty close to axle center line. So I'm just gonna go ahead and I'll just draw my lines. So I made a bit of a modification. I did have it 4 inches above the frame rail, so I was setting it up so that the top of the notch would be 4 inches above. Now I've dropped it down to 3.5, and one of the reasons I did that was because I just don't have the travel in the shockwave to require that much of a notch. And so if I can gain even half an inch of height in the bed, I think I'd rather do that than have, you know, a lot of extra clearance in here. And even that, I should have enough. The Shockwave has about 3 inches from ride height to fully collapsed, and that's straight up and down. But remember, if we lean it over, 3 inches is more. So give it a bit more room, and I think I should still be all right. So I've moved that line, and so now basically the top of the frame is going to be right at the bottom of the notch here. So I'll have the full height of the frame rail as clearance. The other thing is, if I go 4 inches up from the top of the axle to the bottom of the notch, if I even air it out and if this rests on the axle, I'm still going to have an inch and a half of clearance below the cab to the ground. So, you know, even if something breaks and if the truck goes down, I should still have clearance. I won't be dragging frame. That's not the goal of this project anyway. So, and I think I'll now trim this, and we'll go from there. I think what I'm gonna do is plasma cut this. You use the dark art of the plasma. I haven't used it in probably 10 years, so I'm going to test it out on a piece here and then see if I can get it tuned up and cutting nicely, and then I'll use it on that. Now, the other thing that using the plasma lets me do is wear these Cool Dude 3M plasma cutting glasses. This one might be a bit messier because I'm going to have to pierce the side here. Okay, I'm just going to clean this up with a grinder. You all know what that looks like. I've been waiting for an opportunity to use these glasses. It's not every day that you get this sort of an opportunity. I need to go check the fit. I just need to clearance this a bit. You know what that means?